You can get an extra resurrect in Sekiro, so you are able to revive yourself even more or more often. I will tell you how to do it in this video and share even more items and bosses that you don't want to miss in the game. So if you enjoy that, then a like would be super appreciated, and let's go. Let's start with the extra resurrect circle you can get above your health bar. You first have to kill two very powerful bosses for this one though, Lady Butterfly in the Hirata Estate and Janichiro, who is on top of the Ashina Castle. So both will be like midway through the game, but they are very challenging to beat. I got links to guides on how to beat these bosses in the description down below, but in this video I want to focus on what you get from these bosses. So no spoilers for the fights themselves, but a small spoiler for what will happen after the fight, and this is crucial so you can get this extra resurrection circle. So both bosses give you memories that you can use at an idol to permanently increase your attack power, but Lady Butterfly also drops the Sakura droplets that you have to give to Kuro to get an extra resurrection circle. But you can only do this after defeating Janichiro. And again, I will have links to guides on how to beat these bosses in the description down below. So after defeating him, you get the Tower Lookout Idol. But going down gets you access to another idol, the Upper Tower Kuro Room 1. Here you can speak with Kuro as well, but you cannot directly give this droplet yet. You do get the Immortal Severance text and have to talk to Ijin about this. You can find this guy by going back to the Castle Tower Lookout Idol and then go from that idol in a straight line across the roofs to the right, because that is where you will find this room. And speak with him about the Immortal Severance, and then you learn more about what you have to do next in the game. And now you should be able to go back to Kuro and say that you have spoken with Ishin. Now you have the option to present this Sakura droplet that you got from Lady Butterfly, and then you get the extra resurrection circle. So especially if you killed Janichiro before Lady Butterfly, it will be super smart to check back with Kuro to get this really, really powerful enhancement. So it's basically the same circle as the other one that fills after killing people. So this extra circle does not immediately refill after resting at an idol. Also, you only fill one at a time, so doing death blows will only fill the circle that is the furthest at that point, and when that one is full, your kills will count towards the other circle. When you resurrect, the black stripe of course appears, and it will be over both circles, but doing a significant death blow or killing some enemies will of course make this stripe disappear, and then you will not have one but two circles left over. So this basically means that you can have three full circles at one point, but then you still need to remove the black stripe to use the others after you died once. So that's still really, really powerful, because this means that you likely always have that extra circle back up if you keep killing enemies to fill it, and your kills now have a higher chance to fill one of those circles, while before this, with one full circle, they would of course not count. It's a really, really unique perk that is amazing for the rest of the game, so totally go and get it. Janichiro also unlocks something very unique, the Blood Smoke Ninjutsu, that actually opens a locked icon in your inventory. The effect of this skill is super awesome, because it turns the spraying blood out of the victim after a death blow into smoke that you can then use to surprise the other enemies. It's really strong actually, because the other enemies will really have no clue where you are. The ability does cost 6 emblems though, so that is quite a lot. When doing a death blow, you want to use the same attack button again to have this effect trigger, and you do like see the enemies protecting their eyes, so now you can easily attack them without having to worry that they can do anything back. So it's a really awesome and strong attack, but only use it when you are like surrounded by a ton of enemies, because again, the cost is really, really high. Now let's focus on another prosthetic tool. I already showed you the location of the loaded umbrella in my previous video. You can find it near the Lost Grave Idol at the Ashina Castle, at this weird shop that you can get to by jumping through the hole in the roof. But there's actually another prosthetic tool that you can get around this time as well, or actually even earlier in the game. It's at the Ashina Castle Idol, so the first idol for that region. You don't want to go straight, but immediately to the left and grapple to the other side. There is, by the way, a light coin purse to the left here that you might have missed, so totally go grab that. But anyway, what you want to do for this tool is to eavesdrop the two enemies on the bridge and then just slay them to get the gateway house key that you can use to get the loaded spear. But first we want to reach that gatehouse, but luckily it's close by. And by the way, this area looks familiar, and that's because it's the tutorial area, so where you started the game. It's cool that we can visit this again. There will be some tougher enemies now, but you will see that in a second. I just fell down here and got up via the grappling hook, and this will be smart because they will not miss some nice loot. There's namely a rat protecting a heavy coin purse, so 500 coins, and also scrap iron that you of course need for upgrading your prosthetic tools. Go face the wall now, take out this rat as well, annoying creatures, and then just go under the bridge and grapple via this side, and then you will find an idol that you totally want to get. Now you can go and fight or just ignore the enemies in this area. It's smart to take out the gunners either way, since they will be super annoying and shooting you from afar. Sprint and jump to avoid their bullets and kill them with just a few slices. And then it's time to open this small house. It's to the left from the idol, and just like with the other doors, you cannot get hit while the opening animation plays, so that is nice, but you can get hit immediately afterwards, so you want to take this guy out. Luckily they are relatively easy, and just ignore this big girl because she cannot enter either way. There's also a heavy coin purse here, so also really nice to get. But the real prize is of course in the chest, the broken horn. So take that to the sculptor, and then you get the amazing loaded spear that is really powerful, especially in combination with the chasing slash skill from the prosthetic arts skill line. Your range is really long, so being able to immediately follow up with a slash after that is great. It only costs one emblem to use, and later you can upgrade the spear to pull enemies towards you as well, so it's really nice to have. And speaking of spears, there's a spear guy nearby, a mini boss to be exact, that just like the other mini bosses gives you a prayer bead, so you totally want to take him out, and there's actually a smart way to do it. Because just like with the other mini bosses in the game, you can sneak behind him if he hasn't seen you yet. And you do that via the same way you reached Kuro at the beginning of the game. This mini boss is namely standing in front of this house, but if you sneak via the left side, just like it did before, then you will have the chance to get behind him and already take out one of his health bars. So don't use the grapple when you get the chance, but instead climb to get inside the house and behind the boss. If you did not kill the other enemies but did alert them, then they might help this mini boss, so totally focus on them first. The regular soldiers are easy, but if one of the big guys or girls is alerted, then you kind of have a problem. So either take them out before you go to the boss. Sneaking up to them is of course a great tactic to do so. I had one of these big girls against me as well when fighting the mini boss, but I had the chance to kill her after resurrecting and then stabbing her in the back. So wait a little moment, and then when this big girl turns her back to you, you can take her out and then immediately remove the black stripe as well. For this boss, the oil flame fan tactic works really well. So totally throw some oil in the face, and then when you can come close, you want to use the flame fan tool. And I found that the best way to come close is after dodging, especially after his sort of jump attack, because then he will need some time to recover, and that's enough for you to dodge his way and immediately follow up with this flame vent ability. Then immediately go and hit him, so you get some nice damage in, and he will of course get damage over time now as well, thanks to the burning effect. Just like with the Shinobi Hunter mini boss, you want to use the Makiri counter here. So press the dodge button just when the spear is about to hit you, and you of course have that red icon on the screen. You want to parry or deflect all his other attacks, or simply dodge away. So doing this in combination with the oil flame vent combo should be enough to take him out to get the prayer beat. There's one other mini boss that I want to touch on that is near this point in the game. To reach him, you want to go to the antechamber idol and go straight into the room with the grandma and the two soldiers. But if you cannot reach that yet, so when the room is still closed, you want to go to the other room where there are also some enemies and where the secret chamber is as well that I told you about in my previous video. And then you will see the grapple icon, so use that so you can travel via the sort of ceiling to the other room and then drop down. Then just ignore these enemies and go up the stairs on the left to reach this room with an idol. Try to rest here to let the enemies that will follow you go away. And in this room that is now closed, there's a mini boss that can be tricky unless you know what to do. The tactic here namely is to only focus on deflecting his pretty sick double slash attack. So hitting the parry button two times fast after each other when he's about to hit you. Doing this multiple times will break his posture, so then you can take him out. And throwing oil in his face at the start of the fight is also smart here, because after you destroyed his first health bar, you have a perfect moment to use the flame fan tool to make him burn, so you already start the second phase with an advantage. advantage. I finished him with a jump and some slashes, so that can be nice as well to take him out, but mostly focus on the rapid deflect. That will really be the key. And there you have it, some extra nice additions to make your character even stronger in Sekiro Shadows Die Twice. Subscribe for way more Sekiro tips and tricks videos that will be coming your way. Like the video to support the channel, and I already have a ton of other Sekiro videos up on the channel as well. Like I already mentioned, the Secret Rooms video that you can watch by clicking on the screen, and my other video with tips and tricks that every player should know about. For now, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye!